have arranged past also, once we had arranged. Now today the special topic is assault on modern medical profession and professionals in COVID times. This specific topic we have arranged this time because we have seen that in spite of various methods, how the doctors have been working very hard. We have seen that nearly 714 doctors have expired in the last second wave, 1.5 months time. And in government assurance last year that during the epidemic time, after the amendments were taken place, proper precautions will be taken, enough protection will be given to the hospital and paramedical staff and the property. In spite of that, mental, social, physical abuse has taken place. And this assault has really taken a toll of our doctors. They are really mentally disturbed, they are scared. Many times they feel whether they should leave the practice in spite of being in the service. In fact, two doctors have committed suicide, you must have read in paper. Our new generation, which are students at this moment, they are thinking whether they have taken the right path, whether they have gone into the right side, or they should change at this moment of time. So this is a very crucial. We would like to again appeal, and this is the intellectual meet what we have arranged. We have taken a cross section of our friends from various faculties. Very important that in this, there are some doctors are not there. Only that, but there are advocates, there are judges, there are yoga gurus, and there are variety of doctor, other people who know what is the sacrifice made by the doctors. And I'm sure you can see now nearly 80 people have already joined, and then more and more people will join. This is a very crucial, very important meet which will be relayed, which will be recorded. It will be available on the YouTube, it is available on the Facebook, and it is available live at all the media channels what we have got at IMA. And to start this program, I will request our National President Dr. Raya sir to inaugurate this program by lighting the lamp. And then his inaugural address, I will request Dr. Jayaraj sir, our faculty, Dr. Vinay sir, Dr. Sood.
The past national president and the veteran leader of IMA Medical Association, Dr. Vinay Agarwal, the moderator for this session, Dr. Rajiv Shur, the finance secretary, Dr. Anil Goyal, and other distinguished leaders of IMA Medical Association, leaders of IMA Medical Association on the Zoom, and distinguished faculties who are going to talk to us today, Dr. Vikash, Dr. Mukul Kapoor, Dr. Kamlesh Tiwari, Dr. Arun Chandra, Dr. Bhuvanendra, and all other leaders and the media people. We are here today to discuss on a very important topic. What is happening today in the country is varying kinds of assaults happening on the medical professionals and the healthcare, the frontline workers, both in the form of the mental harassment and in the form of the physical assault. It's not only on the professionals, but also on the modern day medical profession. The profession is also attacked, abused, and sarcastic comments are made on the profession. So it's a time for us to discuss and introspect what is exactly happening in this country, why such things are happening, and we thought that it is better that we could get an opinion from the learned colleagues who are being experts in the different kinds of field, so that they will be able to give the perspective view of what the common man and what the public is feeling on this and why this is happening on there. Is we, the doctors, are such a bad people to be assaulted to this horrible extent? The way in which a young doctor in Assam who was beaten brutally by the family of 44 people, and that memory is still not able to be erased from our mind. A young 55-year-old doctor from the Chikmagalur, Karnataka, his skull was broken just because he was a doctor who very carefully treated a young chap with a dengue fever. A doctor in Uttar Pradesh is shot and bared the bullet in his chest, and he is now under the ventilator care to survive his life. Many lady doctors, their life were abused.
And two doctors have to commit suicide in their life. They are not able to bear the brunt of the attack. 75 to 80% of the doctors of this country are facing one or other kind of violence in their professional life. And how far we can go? How will we be able to go? The health of the nation always depends upon the health of the professionals. If the professionals, people are not feeling happy, not feeling safe, not feeling secure, I am sure the health of our country is also not safe and not secure. If the doctor community decides that we will not take any person come with a Glasgow score more than 5 by 55, or if anyone who comes with a very bleeding situation, anyone comes with an acute chest pain, and we will not be able to treat them in the fear of our life, I think there is going to be a disaster in this country. All learned colleagues and like-minded people to come forward and do something to stop this. This is mainly happening because there is no adequate protection is given legally, or adequate implementation of the law, existing law, is done by the responsible people, and the people who do this are going scot-free many times, and they are able to not be traced in the name of their higher associations or their higher position they are enjoying. And to bring this to an end, to bring this to a stop, and we are now rising and standing firmly, and in unison we are raising our voice. Anyone who attack our profession by making their nasty and malefic comments on the profession, or anyone taking the gun or the sticks to breach on the doctor, has to be punished brutally, and that shall be the deterrent to the other people to touch on the profession and the professionals. We are ready for any royal questions. We are ready for any explanation. Modern medicine always has a traditional richness of going with an evidence-based medicine. We are ready to change our perspective. We are ready to change our protocol as per the need and the truth and the scientific evidence coming forward. We are the people who are ready to change, but we are not ready to now face the malefic intention and the nasty comments which are making on us. At this moment, so Indian Medical Association has asked for the views and your opinion, so that we will be retrospectively correct us if there is a mistake on us, and we will be able to stand firm and save and protect our generation. I met a lot of young doctors. They say that, doctor, you talk about empathy, you talk about compassion, you talk about unified focused care to the people when they are coming in the dire need of an emergency. How we can have that mind at this moment of life? My colleague is bleeding to death. When I am seeing that just because he has attended a severe patient, he was brutally attacked. How does he see that I will have a mind to treat another patient when he comes to that? And this agony of the medical students and the young doctors, we need to soothe them out. We need to pacify them. And we need to prove them that it's not so. Our country is not so. Our Prime Minister is ready to support us. The country is ready to support us. But it has to be come in black and white. So that we are asking a law of central law to be exclusively and explicitly saying, anyone who attacks on the doctors will be punished. One of the most important things we want to raise at this moment, and vulnerable the intellectual faculties also. If you see any hospital, it has to have 72 acts to be followed in an hospital. It talks about biomedical waste, it talks about the fire safety, it talks about many other things, but never on the human safety, never on the security structure. And there is no criteria to say how much security to be there to protect the doctor then. Even the Medical Council of India, the National Medical Commission, which says the minimum standard requirement of the medical college, there is no statutory requirement or the security requirement. So that has to be happened. Now it has to become a mandatory part of any hospital. Like what the hospital has to have a fire safety license, the hospital should also have a security safety license. It should be enough security. The most of these attacks is happening in government medical colleges. Most of this has happened in a government setups. It is the responsibility of the government now to come out with a structural auditing and the security system to be incorporated into the hospital, so that it is not our aim to arrest the culprit. It is our aim to prevent such incidents. That no one should have dare enough to come forward and attack the doctors. We have enough legal system. We have enough system of grievance redressal, and we have to strengthen them. We have to provide an opportunity for them to express their feeling. All that we welcome. All that we then. If the doctor is found to be wrong, and we are the first people will be there forward to punish them. But not, no one should take law in their hand. And if the people started taking law in their hand and start punishing the doctor, that is going to jeopardize this harmony which is existing today, and let will land up our country in a very difficult situation. For that, we are calling for a national protest day. We do not want to close up the hospital or punish any of our common people. So we are going to make our voice heard. Our vibrations and our anguish and our pain will be resonated in the corridors of power on day of 18. And every nook and corner will say that, doctors save the saviors. And with that slogan, we are going forward. And to make that happen, and we are arranging this intellectual meet, I am sure our honorable and dignified members, both representing the different sectors of the life, and give us some inputs, guidance, and ways forward to go and to ensure the professionals can practice with safe, without fear, and render justice to their calling. I want to reiterate the prayer every day Indian Medical Association is making. I do not want to be in heaven or not reborn, but I only want to alleviate the suffering of humanity. We will work with that. We will work with that motto. Please help us to do that in the days to come. Thank you very much.